In this video, I'm going to remake this section of the Max Martinez website in the Figma, which you can see that we have this scroll effect. Whenever I scroll down or scroll up, the sections are going to scroll over each other. If you watch this video, you're going to learn how to use the auto layout and the properties that we have in the prototyping section in order to make such an effect. And in addition, I'm going to show you some advanced tricks using variables in order to build more usable components. You can also share the web pages or the effect that you want me to remake it in a Figma in the Discord channel that I have. So join there right now. You can find the link to the Discord server in the description of this video. Now, without further ado, let's get started. My name is Kia and here is Kimo. Welcome to my channel. First of all, I'm going to work on the design of the sections that are going to scroll over each other. So I'm going to remake those things in my file. Let's jump to the Figma file. You can see that I have already imported all the styles and the content that I need in order to rebuild those sections, such as the videos and the text content, including the headline and the paragraph text, and the styling things, such as the fonts that I'm going to use or the font size, and of course the color that I'm going to use as the background color for each section. First of all, I would like to make one frame, which is going to be basically the section that we have. So we are going to collect the image and the text within that. So let's pick up the frame tool and I'm going to make one random size frame, and then I'm going to rename it to section. Just to get closer to the design that we would like to have at the end, I would select the section frame, and as a background color, I'm going to select this dark purple, which is going to be basically the background color for the first section. In this step, I would like to just focus on redesigning and building the layout of each section. So I'm going to pick up one of the assets that we have very randomly, this video and these two text layer, copy them and bring them into section frame that we made. Okay, you can see that the section that we made at the beginning is very huge, 7,869 pixel width and 4,442 pixel height. So I'm going to resize it. For now, it doesn't matter how much, but I'm going to just make it a little bit smaller to have more realistic look here. And then I'm going to apply auto layout on the main parent frame, the section here for now. Okay, in the next step, I'm going to get sure that the elements are in the right position. So first of all, I'm going to take this headline that we have and position it above the video by just changing the order of the layers, because we have the auto layout applied on section frame. Then I'm going to group the video that we have and this paragraph text together. I'm going to select these two and apply the auto layout, basically make a new frame and apply auto layout on that frame using the combination key shift A. Okay, here now let's reduce the gap between these two child layers. I'm going to set it on maybe 36, or let's make it 48. Actually, I didn't check what exactly is the amount of the gap between these two elements in the reference design. Let's rename this frame to content. And then I'm going to select the section frame that we had. And I would like to reduce the gap between meta gravity, or the headline, and the content section. Even I would like to have a little bit minus amount there in order to kind of have overlap between the headline and the video. So I can do this by just grabbing this handle here, or I can do it from the properties panel in auto layout section. So let's do it right here. But here you can see that the video is kind of hovering over the headline. So let's come here in the advanced setting for the auto layout. And here the canvas stacking, I would like to change it to first on top. So basically based on the order of the layers, the stack is going to overlap each other. So right now it's on first on top. So the headline is also the first layer. So it's going to be on top of the next layer, which is the content section. In this step, I'm going to select this content and the headline and make another frame and apply auto layout on that as well. The reason I'm doing this is that I would like to define some max width for this section that our design is not going to get kind of broken when I start to resize the section in a horizontal direction. So let's do this. And here in the auto layout section, I'm going to get sure that the behavior of, or resizing behavior of this element is in the way that I would like to have it. Right now it's on the fill, which means if I change the scale the section in the horizontal direction, you can see that it's going to kind of fill the container, the parent container. And that's not the behavior I want. I would like to have a fix, or in best case, I would like to have a maximum width for this element, so it's not getting bigger than a specific amount. But for now, just keep it simple. I'm going to make it fix, sorry, not the section, but the element within it. I'm going to set the horizontal behavior in the auto layout section to fix width. And now if I start to resize the parent layer, you can see that it's not going to have impact on that element. But the other problem I found here right now is that we have to have center alignment for the section layer, section frame. So I'm going to select the section frame, and here in the auto layout properties panel, I'm going to set the alignment to the center. Now we can see that our text here is started from left side, so it has a left alignment, which is not the case in the reference. So I'm going to select this one and set the text alignment to the right side. But as you can see that if I start to type more text here, it's going to kind of fill whole space that we have here in the parent container. And I don't want this to happen. I would like to have a kind of max width for this layer as well. So one more time, I'm going to select the text layer. And here in the horizontal resizing behavior in the layout section, I open this drop-down menu and select the add max width. Here I can kind of select the amount or the maximum width that I would like to have for this element. So I'm going to set it on maybe 470. It's a very random amount. Maybe a little bit more. Let's make it 500. And then I'm going to select the content frame, which is holding the video and this text, and set the alignment of this frame also to the right. Now our layout is ready. So I select the section layer and set the final height that I would like to have, maybe 1080, maybe a little bit more. I don't know how much is in the reference web page. I can check it, but I'm a little bit lazy. So maybe we increase it to 1200. And here I'm going to make it 1980. So this is the section that I will have in a final design. Now the section is ready. I can copy paste this one and change the content within it, change the video that I have, change the background color, and build the other section that I need in my design. However, I would like to convert this to the component to have more control on these sections later on if I want to maintain something in my design. And I'm gonna show you how the process is going to be. I'm gonna select the section frame, and here on top in the properties panel, I'm going to click on this icon, which you already can see from the tooltip that is going to create a component. Of course, you can use the combination key Ctrl+Alt+K to do the same action. Now I have two ways to go further with. The first way is to make different variants for this component. Each variant is going to be basically for each section that I need for my design based on the reference web page. I can select, for example, this component that I made and click on this plus button here on the right side in the properties panel and add a new variant. Change the thing that I need to change, such as the background color and the text and the video, and then make this variants for other four or three section that I need, and then I'm done. Maybe in this case, actually, for this video, this process that I show you right now is much easier, but I'm gonna show you something else, which I'm going to use variables to have control on the content. Now, the second way. In the second way, I'm going to define variable for each element that I have in my design, such as this headline, video, and the paragraph text here, and of course the background color. And then I'm gonna use those variables to store the amount that I want to show here. So I'm going to click somewhere on the empty space of the canvas and then open the local variable panel by clicking on this icon here. First thing first, I'm going to rename the collection that we have here to content, and then I'm going to make my first variable. I'm going to make one string variable as a first variable that I have in my collection. So I'm going to rename it to headline. This variable is going to store the text of the headline. Then I'm going to duplicate this one. This one is going to basically store the text for the paragraph text that we have here. I'm going to just name it as a text. And then for the video as well, we need to have one string variable. So this one is going to store the name of the video, which I'm going to use in order to switch between different videos. And at the end, we need one color for the background color of our section. In the first approach, we had to make different variants for each section that I need to have in my design based on the reference website. Here, I would like to use different modes to store different values. So basically, I need to just change the mode later on for this component to see different content here, because I have already stored everything in my collections. I have one limitation here. I can only have maximum four mode with the license that I have. So I cannot make five section, but let's just give a try and build how much that we can. So this is the maximum mode that I can have. The first mode, I'm going to rename it to section one. I'm going to rename the rest three, and section four is the last one. I'm going to get back to the information or the assets that I collected. I'm going to select the headline first one for the first section and paste the value here for the headline variable. I'm going to do the same thing for the text, and then I'm going to select, or I can do it from here. I'm going to select the color for the BG color of the first mode. I need to do this thing for the rest of the asset that I have here for the section two, basically headline, the value for the headline. I copy that and I do the same thing for the background color. Now we have the values for all the variables inside my collection. Everything is fine. So the headline for the section one is going to be meta gravity. The section two is going to be risk ledger, and the rest, as you can see. However, for the video, we need to think a little bit differently. The way that I can change the video for each section is basically assigning a name here for it and a string, a text. And then I have to convert all the videos that we have here to a component set. And I need to connect this variable to that properties, which is going to kind of change or control the variant of the video component. And in that case, I can control the video that I want to see in the section. So let me very quickly show you. First of all, I'm going to select all these videos, and then before that, you get sure that you have a proper naming, because this naming is really important later on. These are basically the values that I'm going to give to variables that I made. I'm going to make a component set. And then when I made a component set, first of all, rename this component to video. Here in the properties, you can see that I made one variant properties, basically. I'm going to change the name of this property name to video. And then you can see that the values are video, like values for that properties are video number one, video number two. I don't know why the name didn't change. Let me just change it again. First thing first, I'm going to go to the asset panel and replace the video that I have here right now in the section designs, the section layout, with one of the instances of the video that I made, the video component that I made right now. And then I'm deleting the other video. So basically we have now this instance here, which I can change the video by just changing the value for the properties of that component. I'm going to open the local variables again. And here I'm going to set for each section, I'm going to set the name of the video that I would like to see there. For example, here, the video one is going to be the value that I'm going to store for the video variable for the section one. And then I'm going to basically do the same thing for the rest. And here we go. Our variables are ready, basically. Okay, we can now connect every element that we have here to the variables and control them via the variables. I'm going to start with the background color of this section. I'm going to select this section. And here I'm going to open in the field, basically properties in the properties panel. I'm going to open the variable panel in the library, and I'm going to select the variables that I'm going to connect. I want to connect it to this properties or attribute. Basically now connect our background color to the variable that I made. Next step is the text for the headline that we have here, which I'm going to do the same thing again. Here I have this apply the variable, which when I click it, I can see the variable that I made for the headline, and I select this and I connect basically the value that I want to see here in this text to that variable. Let's do that the same for the text as well, very quickly. Now the text and headlines are connected to the variable. We need to connect the value of the properties that is controlling the variant of the video, which you can see here right now. So if I change the value, it's going to change the video as well, which is making sense. I need to connect this one to the variable that I made for the video. Our component is ready. Now let's check out our result. Here we have the component. Even without having any variant for this component, I can change the content within it using the mode. So here in the appearance section, I'm clicking on this button, which is basically controlling the modes of this frame. And then I can switch between the four modes that I made myself in the local variable panel. So I'm going to click on the section two. You can see that the content is going to change that one and the rest working as well. Now let's build the final frame that we need to run in our preview, and then we have that scrolling effect that we saw in the reference web page. So I'm gonna make one random size frame and then rename it preview. I'm gonna run this frame basically at the end. Then I'm gonna drag and drop one instance of the section component that we made from the asset panel, which is already open here, you can see. Then select the preview frame and apply auto layout on that. And let's get rid of the paddings that we have, which is not really necessary. Then I'm going to change the width of the preview panel for now to 1920. And later, actually, we are going to run the preview in the responsive mode, so it doesn't matter. Then let's get sure that the orientation of the layout that we have in the auto layout is on the vertical, because we want to have a stack of the sections on top of each other. Then I'm going to copy paste this instance of the component that we made three times to have a one instance for each frame, and then change the mode to the section that I would like to see there. For example, the section one, section two, section three, and the last one, section four. Let's also get rid of this white space here. We have 10 pixel gap, which I'm going to remove it completely. Now only one step left, in which we need to define the scroll behavior of each section. We want that when each section actually reached to the top of the page, to the top of the viewport, then it stops scrolling, there's a stick there, and the next section scroll over it. That means we need to kind of define a sticky behavior for this section. So when they arrive to the above of the viewport, they stop there. I'm gonna select this sections, and then in the prototyping panel we have the scroll behavior, which makes sense, huh? We want to define the scroll behavior, and we have this properties here, which is amazing. Here we have this position attribute, which I open it right now. In the default state is on the scroll with the parent, which means it's going to get scrolled with the parent layer, which is the preview itself. So it means basically the normal scrolling behavior. I just need to switch to the sticky, which is already explained that it's gonna stop at the top of the edge of the parent layer. Now let's run the prototype. Before I continue with my prototype, I would like to set the prototype mode on the responsive mode, which for now doesn't matter so much. And of course, hide the UI to have the realistic feeling that I would have if I opened the web page. So now if I start to scroll, you can see that each section kind of slide over the previous step and stick to the top of the parent layer, which was our viewport basically. So we build the same exact scroll behavior that we had in our reference web. And that was it for this video. I hope you learned something new, and if it was so, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and share this video with the other designers in your community. And it's very valuable for me to hear your opinion and thought in the comment section. I'm gonna definitely try to respond to all of your questions that you are sharing with me in the comment section. And besides that, one more time, please join to my Discord channel and server. That's the place that we're gonna kind of discuss about the design topics. We're gonna share the problems that we have, the ideas, and in general, we're gonna get closer to each other and build our community. Let's learn together, and see you in the next video.